Kids. The following program is rated TV-MA-LSV. It contains strong language, sexual situations, violence, and nudity. It is intended only for mature audiences.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Big Lou Show. Yes, we are here. We are here for you. And you, and you, and you. Yes, you are all Mr. Bev in the house. We've got the double door in the house. And look at that, Mr. Tom. Mr. Tom, we are going to be joining up with Mr. Tom soon enough because we are going to be going over all of the new in updates, going over some of your questions. Maybe you might have some answers, but we're going to be able to actually go over some stuff maybe that may have been given some trouble that Tom has been helping out with. Botrix is with us. As you could see, Mr. Botrix has joined. And then, not only that, my trusty dog Piper, she comes over. She hears the show. It's funny because sometimes I'll be sitting here and I'll be doing something and something will come on and she'll be like, "Hey, the show started. We're going to come on the show." Hey, Mrs. Piper, how you doing today? Hey, I'm doing good. Hey, Mr. Invisible Rob in the background. Mr. Invisible Rob, hello, say hello.
Hey, hello. How's everybody doing out there?
Hey, Mr. Rob, how you doing?
I got a teddy on tonight. Yeah.
I see that, Invisible Rob. It's very lacy. Yes, it is. Yeah. That's Invisible Rob. That he's on the New York show, but he doesn't come on mine. He stays in the background, as you could hear. He is so much fun on my show. It's ridiculous. All right, Mrs. Piper, thank you for showing up and coming on the show with us. As you could see, the Rangers are my team. You know that I love my Rangers. Yes, they took the President's Trophy, and we are in first place, and we are going to be playing the Washington Capitals. Are any of you people out there Washington Capitals fans? Are you? Maybe you are. Duke is in the house. Look at that bastard Duke. Look at you, you pretty man. I'm only working off of one ear. One of them didn't charge today. Is that crazy or what? Yeah. Ha ha. Let's do this. Let's see. Let's check in. Mr. Bebev, how you doing? All right. Let's check in with Bebev. You know how we like to start the show. Before we even start the show, we start with Bebev. Here he is. Let's look at him.
Yep, that worked. I do went into that registrations and installer thing and...
Oh, you got it.
We're back in business, folks.
Bev is back. Let's see what he does.
Since I got you, watch this.
Yeah, I'm going to watch it. Watch this. He's going to really do it. He's going to show us something special.
Like the looks of this one, it's just fine.
Yeah, I can do better.
Could do better, Mr. Bev. Could do better. Thank you, Mr. Bev. Bev is with us. He did his updates. He's got everything going. He's still got some trouble. I think he's got a problem with his windows. It just won't stay the set. He said he had a problem. Way to keep it in the fairway. What a good guy he is, that Bev. Yeah, what's up, man?
Wow!
Yeah!
I feel good.
Come on, Piper, dance. Dance, baby. We all feel good.
I feel good.
Woohoo! Working on a one-ear piece. Not this side. Because it's charging. I got my portable charger sitting here charging that bass boy up so I can get for shots on the week and I can hear all your beautiful voices and all your beautiful boops and everything else. What are we, everybody? If you're joining me and you don't know what this is a community golf show for the Global VR Cabinets, which we play online with a private server. So if you happen to get a good deal in your town and you get a PGR, BGA, Global VR Cabinet, that is what we are. That is what we do. This is a fit. And I got a Facebook group on there. And what happens is that you join the Facebook group and then get your cabinet up and running. And then there's a lot of stuff you got to get prepared. We are all excited because just recently, Mr. Brian and the team and everybody along with everybody that could possibly kick in and help, Mr. Michael got the online course thing going on. We're going to talk about that. It is amazing. And there's a lot of stuff coming to us. which is going to be really cool, and I'm looking forward to this because there's one called the Big Lou Ravine, and that is badass, if you ask me, and I can't wait to play that with everybody. But, all right, let's move on now. We're going to get going here. We're going to do this. Let's do it. It is, what day is it? Let's see. Wayne Paperboy is buddy. Oh, I just, there he is. Oh, no, that's not it. No, oh, what happened here? It moved on me. Oh, that was a surprise. Surprise. Hey, Thursday.
Thursday. I'm so happy it's Thursday.
My mouth batteries are dying.
Thursday. I'm so happy it's Thursday. Throw
the ball. Come on. What day is it?
Thursday.
How do you spell it?
T-H-U-R-S-D-A-Y. Thursday.
Today is Thursday. And you know what Thursday is? Thursday is the Big Lou Show every other week. We are with you to show you how much fun we could have. The points, here we go. Let's get it started because I want to get Tommy on here. Let's cruise through this show right now. We're going to do this. Settings won't keep after Bev shuts down. I know, Bev. I think we have a corrupt hard drive, maybe Windows, because we tried duplicating the hard drive and try to do that and try a new hard drive, even though that sometimes could really mess you up. But it didn't. So we walked Bev through that, but it didn't help. He's got his situation there. Hopefully it's not a controller on the motherboard that's giving you an issue, because there is another thing that I was worried about, and that could be that. But let's move on. Let's not worry about that, Bev. Let's try to get something going. Here it is. Let's show over. This is what we do. We go over the weekly scores. This is what we do online with the private server. So you're going to see what's going on. Mr. Feathers taking it over again. Mr. Feathers is back. He's from Victoria, Australia. Mr. Feathers. He put a shrimp on the bobby and hit some golf balls in the holes. Yes, he did. Mr. Feathers showing you with an 85 under. Ronnie D right there in Missouri doing it with you for an 83 under. Ronnie D showing up this week. No shots in a week from Ronnie D. Is that interesting? But look at that Shermanator. He's coming back. He feels it. He really feels it. MEC coming up. There's Mike Claiborne. Here he is. And he is Mikey. Mike C. And Mr. Drummer, Mr. Tommy there with you in the fifth place. Robbie D showing right up in sixth. Look at that. No shots in a week from them. But we got a Timbo shot. Yes, we do. In seventh place. Big Brian Grieve, the brain right there. 74 under. We got the Cash. He's showing up with a 73 under. And then we got Todd Bruce right there. Yes, Todd is still around, even though we don't see him anymore. He is still available. He plays, and it's a nice Masters win with Feathers right there. He has taken it right there, the green jacket, and you got a little splash of what is to show you what's going on there. You probably saw it when I popped it up because my mouse batteries are dying and it's choosing the wrong stuff. But I just hooked the cordless mouse up while you guys were watching the Thursday thing. How great is that, huh? Hey, let's have a drink with you. Yes, you got a nice summertime drink with you. Thank you very much for joining me, Mr. Big Lou, on Thursday. Yes, that is some good hearty stuff. That'll put the thing. There's my Rangers right there. Let's throw him. All right, let's show him. Mr. Feathers, look at him. There he is. There's getting the jacket from Mike right there. Mike is handing him his green jacket and putting it on Mr. Feathers. What a beautiful shot of them. He looks very happy. Look at how happy. And Mike has just completely lost his friggin' mind. Thank you, Mr. Cord, for that graphic deal. That was beautiful. Originally had me on there. I was going to put me and then stop him stealing the jacket from Mr. Feathers. But nope, we can't do it. It's a beautiful thing. Congratulations. Look at that. Everybody's saying Thunder Spy is in the house. Look at Thunder Spy. Hello. Yes, if you're in there, just say something in the chat and... we can respond if you have any questions or whatever. If you're one of the new people online and you have any questions or whatever, I can answer them for you. And then not only that, Mr. Tommy's going to be here too, so he'll be able to answer. Man, I got super thirsty. Let me have another sip here. All right, so we also had the Saturday. This is one of the new courses. So you have installed your Michael Online patch, and you will be playing this course here, which is the Augusta Par 3 with... Having fun with Augusta. This is what a wonderful week. Look at this new thing here. T-Dog and 16 under taking the whole thing. Look at that. Tony showing everybody where it's at. Good old Tony, man. Love that guy. I got to get a pinball machine together for a virtual pinball I got going on. Mr. Jarts in second, me C. Francis in third. Look at the big D. Hear me, Lou. That's Mr. Rob himself. Hey, Rob, look at you go. Taking over Abe. And then I was going to put the helicopter video thing that you had with Mr. Shermanator's game going right into the hospital, but because you took him over with a nice stroke on Mr. Shermanator. Takes over. Does great for the week, but doesn't do good on Saturday. Usually he's the opposite. Timbo's still showing up. He's in seventh place. He's always either in the middle or I'm right in the bottom of the middle. And there's MEC. MEC had to fight it out with Feathers. Feathers there might have taken the jacket, but they didn't show up on Saturday with this Augusta Par 3. Everybody trying to get used to it. You know, you try some fancy stuff and you end up like Feathers there in ninth place. And there is Mr. Tommy Man showing you what it is. And then I just squeeze under there with a 13. Let me see anybody. Lily Girl's playing this one. Look at her in there. Not six under. She's got a shot at a week. What a beautiful scoreboard that was. Huh? How about that for you? I show you it all for you. Let's see what's going on. Everybody's congratulating Feathers with the win there. And Bev is happy. He's having a good time. And Thunderbar Spy saying hello. He's a happy guy saying hello to you. Yeah, so, all right. So we got the Saturday. So in case you're watching the show and you don't have a global VR cabinet, nor is there one around you, there is an online version called Steam 2K21. And in societies, look for Putting from the Rough. That is the show that has this scoreboard on it. And right now, there's not many people playing, but there are very special few. And let's see what they did. The points are, Dodge Ram 9 takes it back again. He was having a little bit of a slump, but he says, no, no, no. He says, you are not going to do it to me this week, Mr. Sherm. He takes the first spot and takes Sherm to two. Corey R. still gets in there and shows you what it's doing. Miss Shermanator, really, really amazing. Lily Girl right there, amazing. Taking fourth out, taking the brain, which had first place a couple weeks ago when I was on. Holy cow, and Foster, there's six people playing it. That was at the Shy Peaks Resort in Canada. It was what a course. I wish I had more time in my day. This damn work is killing me. I would just like to play some damn golf. I'm retiring. I'm selling everything. In my... Look at you. Let's see what Bev is saying. Still what? Waiting for you to take a pull, Big Lou. Yeah, Mr. Bev, we don't have that around here. It's not legal in North Carolina over here like it is up in New York where those guys could take a pull at any time. If I did, I don't know. Sheriff's officer might come knocking. Wink, wink, wink. Yeah, that's it. I don't know. I mean, I don't have anything over here. They do have edibles. I mean, they have it. I mean, they have the pipe that you could take the no-hitter stuff and all that stuff around. But you know how it is. Everybody's hiding it. Let's see what happened with the points now that things got shuffled around. Dodge Ram 9 takes back over again, but the Shermanator only has 12 events played. So Dodge Ram 9 just squeezing up on 4,500 points there with 38 with Sherm. The Brain's still fighting it out with the... Now, this could happen. This could switch up with the second place and the third place, guys. Now, Brain could take over Shermanator. Shermanator's fighting it out. Foster is in fourth. Corey R. is in fifth. There she is. Lily Girl showing up and making it up on the scale there, taking over six. Hiko Man still in there, and Coffee Man, and then there is Mar. Mar is new and played one round, one event. Yes. Congratulations to Corey on his win. If you were watching Savage Edge Racing, Corey had taken the first place. I watched some of that race, and then I got a little tired, fell asleep, and then YouTube closed down, and I didn't get to see the rest of the race. But he did win first place. Congratulations to Corey on that. Thank you very much. All right, let's move along. Let's get moving now. Let's start cruising through this. We got to get Tom on here. All right, Philip, and here he is. PJ After Dark, this is where you get a handicap system. Here he is. Mr. Feathers took this one. He took this one out with the handicap and all. He said, nah. He goes, I took the back jacket, and I'm taking this one. And then Mike Clayton, MEC, the three top guys. Adam takes it in. Rodney Day showing up. Jamie Stark, there he is in fifth. CJ Loveass. Loveass right there in sixth place. And there he is, Tommy showing up all week long for you. There's the Andy man. Andy's coming in eighth. Chris Rusnick, Steve, the Stutz Stutler, Stutz 10. Timbo gets pushed out of that one to 11th. Oh, let's see who else is in. Anybody else in there? Mr. Bev didn't play that week. Look at that. No, I don't want to dance. I want to just get rid of it. I'm all over the place. Yeah, Mr. Bev didn't play some After Dark, but he was probably up at the cabin having a good time, right, Mr. Bev? He's always tired. I'm always tired. It's amazing, right, Bev? Oh, man. It doesn't end this part. That's for you, Bev. Good stuff right there. I moved over. As you can see, I'm a little over this way. Because Tom's going to be over here. All right, let's move on. D1, let's do this. Mike Clayton there showing up in first place. All right, Feathers in second place. Mr. Tommy in third place. I got Steve. Guru! Mr. Ronnie Day in fourth place there. Robbie Davis in fifth. Corey Sherman in sixth place taking it out. That is a cutoff of the PGA putting from the rough after dark. Those guys going there. Sold the cabin. Oh, that's right. Mr. Bev going to Arizona. Family's there now. Are you doing all the watching the dogs? God bless you too, bud. I'm glad. Going to be going to Arizona where it's nice. The weather's nice. Everybody's nice down here. Peaceful. Having a nice time. But boy, Bev got some nice things. Let's go to D2. Harley Hodge taking D2 in first place. Steve the Stud Stutler, number two. I'm sorry, Harley Hodge, number one. And Steve the Stud Stutler, number two. I got tongue-tied there. Paul the Kish Cushman taking third place. Timbo going fourth. Division two. Brian the Brain Grieve in number five. There he is. Jacob J.R. Rod going up sixth. Jamie Stark seventh. Adam Abe in this one doing it eighth. And then Andy showing up in ninth because nobody else played. Look at this. Let's see who's not playing. See Francis Bishop. T-Dog took the other one. But Tom Bruce. Brute. See, look at Todd. He's just playing a weekly. He's like, I don't have time for this other crap. So, things are probably going to get shuffled around. Tom's going to be shaking things up if people don't start playing. You guys, well, it's kind of springtime. And yeah, it is. Yeah, we always seem to get that. It's a lull in the season, don't we, Tom? We always do that. We'll talk about that later. All right, let's go to D3 where I'm at. Let's see. All right. Chris Rusnick showing up at number one. Chris Lovis right there. Lovass right there. Number two taking over at 19-18. Pushing Big Lou down to number three. Why are those two guys in goddamn the third play? D3, they should be in D1 with the way they play. I always say that in the chat and get a kick out of that. I always laugh when I say that. There's Micaiah. There he is. Micah McAllister. There he is. And then we got John Loop. Loopy Zwick. I can only say that name. Loopy Zwick. Loopy Zwick. There we go. Takes a little while, but my mouth gets warmed up. There she is, Lily girl, showing up. She was mad when I pushed her out. And then after that, the other two came in. But Lily girl showing up right there, number six. Keith. Look at Keith. Madman, number seven. James. Loopy Zoic. Yeah, I like that one. I see. I got that right out. Mr. Eric Pennington showing up. And there he is. Mr. Bev squeezing it in the 10th spot. There he is. And there's a lot of people playing in that D3. So that D2, they got some competition down in D3 because everybody's playing that one. Woohoo! Yeah, you did, Bev. You really did. I know that you said something happened with the putting. I've been... I got a new cabinet that I'm putting my system in. I've got a pedestal. I'm going to show it to you later. Tom, I added that in. You don't have that on the script, but I figured when you come on, we're going to go over that together. All right, let's do this. Let's do the shots of the week. Get to Tom. Never mind. We're going to go over the promos. This week, we got the RBC Heritage right April 15th to 21st. We're going to do the PGA Signature event in South Carolina. Oh, yeah. This seven-time play with the PGA Pros. We're playing again with the PGA Pros this season. There's going to be a lot of that now with the new courses. Congratulations to Philip Feathers on his green jacket win. Look at that, the Masters. Harbortown Golf Links, $3 for 18 holes. What a deal. You got to have $3 for 18 holes, and we'll have a good time with that. Here it is, 2K21 schedule. This one is in... Banzai Golf Club Card GC Japan. I don't know what that is. GC Golf Course in Japan. The Banzai. There it is. He's got that going on. 2K21 Society Steam if you want to play. That is it, man. We are moving. I'm going. DG is starting to push me to start practicing. Bev is going to practice. He's going to be. And then when he does, you guys are all seriously in trouble. That's going to start doing it. But you got more time, Bev. You're moving. You know, it's not easy. You got a lot going on. Hey, what do you got to, you know? You're like me. I never could. I barely find a time for myself to sit on the couch, nonetheless to play golf. All right, now let's go over the divisions promo right below me. Look for this week's challenge matches. If you're playing in the weekly challenge, D1 is Great North, which also follows with the After Dark White North. So those guys are playing the handicap and they play the other thing. So switch it around. There we go. And then D2's doing the Pred. Oh, we did the Pred last week, I think. Oh. And I had a hard time. I hit the wall. I hit that damn, you know, you get stuck and you can't get through the thing. I thought I can make it with a nice... Nope, not doing it. All right, Troon, for the D3 guys. That's me. We're playing some Troon. I don't know if I'm going to be able to play the Troon this week. If I can get my cabin together in time, hopefully I do because I really want to play. I'll have a video on that. I'm going to show you in a little while. All right, let's do this. Let's get your shots of the week. Let's do this. I'll get this wheel up while this is doing.
Today's a monumentous day, people.
Mr. Wayne Paperboy.
Disrespect. A lot of hurt thrown my way over the quality of my machine and the quality of my golfing game.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Fuckers.
I cannot find the wheel. They moved something around on me here. They moved it around. I don't know what they did with the widgets. Oh, there they are. Oh, widgets. I don't know if you can see me or not. You probably can. There we are. They moved this stuff around on you, and they expect you to know where it is. Like, I have enough time to go. Look at this. Learn some basics with this. Yeah, I have enough basics. We're going to spin the wheel. They're trying to teach me how to spin the wheel now, them bastards. Here we go. Oh, yeah. Let's see what's happening there. Let's see what, ladies and gentlemen. Evan Peach, woohoo! Where is it? Right here, baby. Right here, right in front of me. Look at some little Evan Peach there. Where's this stuff from? I don't know, but it's good stuff. What is Botrix? Botrix is a madman. Botrix is out of control. Botrix has a lot of control over this shit. I don't even want to talk about Botrix. I can't get in the first place with Botrix. Now let's do this, everybody. Shot of the week. Let's do shots of the week here. Iris, to you guys, we do a nice shot. I'm going to do two shots with you today. We're going to spin that wheel again later. What happened? Oh, she locked you out? You locked the Piper out. She's so pissed off. Piper's over there. She's so mad at me. Give me 1 second. I gotta let Piper in. What happened? Mommy did that to you? She did? Bastard. Mommy clocked the dog out, and the dog likes to sit below my feet over here. There you go. I wish I could flip the camera around. She's laying on her belly. She's laying upside down looking for belly rubs. That's what she does. All right, let's start it off. Miss Amanda.
The water.
Steve DeSutz, thank you, bud. Look at Amanda's shot of the week.
Oh, shit, a little more.
Look at that. Beautiful shot, Lily girl.
Oh, okay, good.
Because
I'm not fast enough.
She was going to record the shot.
I wasn't expecting it, but.
Tell Lou to put it on a show.
Lou, put it on your show.
I sure will.
Boop.
Oh, beautiful job. That was nice. She was ready to get her camera. She had it all ready, but does she little know? She had. Mr. Corey was streaming that bass, boy. Look at that. Beautiful shot. Here's to you, man. Thank you so much for that shot of the week. Let me just check on Tom, make sure everything is working good. Mr. Tom, show us the shot of your week. Tom has shot number one.
Popped her cherry.
Look at that, Mr. Tom. It was while you were doing that I was starting collab camera, getting that ready to go. Streamlabs looks different than previous. I just had to start it. They closed down and it closed the thing down. Piper was below me, messing me up. There it is, Mr. Tom showing you there. Let's go to Brad. Mr. Boy, Brad. He didn't know he was gonna be on. Yeah, I love that. See, that's gonna be me soon with the TV. I'm gonna show you a video when Mr. Tom comes on later. Let's go down, Mr. Keith. Keith had a shot of the week. Let's see, Streamlabs, okay. Is it normal now, Tom? While we're showing Keith, I'm going to take a peek in there. I think I seen you. I see you in there, Tom. Shrink that down. Bring you on in a little bit. All right. Cruising along. Beautiful shot there. That was there with Mr. Keith. Now let's show Timbo. Mr. Timbo's showing you right here. That beautiful high definition screen. You guess what's on in the background? You wouldn't guess, would you? Yes, he is. He's got the Masters on. All right, here he is. Mr. Tom, shot number two. You can see in the window there. Look at them big arms. You got the guns going with the camera there. The guns. All right. And Mike Clayton's got a little bit of a montage. Here he is to show you. Shot one, two, three, and four. Or five. As you can see, there's a bunch of them. I joined them all together so you can get just a montage of his beautiful shots. You can see what he's doing here. He's shooting over things. Would like to see him stream one day. You know what I mean? Like Corey does. There's another one. There's the last one. Tom's at level three. Bot Ritz, he's got you level three. He doesn't go no boop, no nothing. It's just quiet. So I got to talk over his thing. Double door. Look at that. Oh, finally we get to see a little shot. No wind. That flag isn't moving. And the last one, you got a hole in one. I gotta make sure I got Tom's mic right. All right. Oh, why isn't Tom there? Shoot. What's going on here? Oh, I gotta start him. Whoops-a-daisy. There you go, Tom. I didn't show you on stream here. Let's make sure that's working. There it is. There he is. Mr. Tom, can you hear? Can everybody hear him?
Can everybody hear me?
I just got to wait for a second. Make sure I did the cam right. I think they're going to be good. I can hear you perfectly good, but last time that was the same thing last time, and then yeah. They couldn't hear you.
All right, Andy says yes.
Yeah, we
Corey
go.
Corey says yes. There we go. We're good. Awesome.
Welcome, Mr.
Thanks.
Tom.
Thanks for having me on.
Yes, I'm so glad that we got to come on and talk about the updates. I got some stuff loaded up. Tom's got some screenshots to show you as he's going to go through it for you. He's going to be telling you exactly what to do. What I wanted to do is first, before we go through that, is discuss how has everybody been doing after we had the unzipping and all that other stuff. Is it still in a RAR format? While we have a chance, we'll tell everybody exactly that they have to follow the instructions exactly or it doesn't work.
Yeah, I tried uploading one that was unzipped and it seems that Google Drive just automatically zipped some stuff back up anyway. Mm-hmm. So Micah McAllister let me know that it zips things on its own. So I took that down because if you're going to have to unzip, you might as well just unzip the way I've already posted on the Facebook page. So I think for the most part, it's going well. I probably got 30, 40 people have already done it. I'm judging from the leaderboards, that it seems like a lot of people have mm-hmm. had success, that both the Augusta National and the Augusta Par 3 had a lot of players on the leaderboards. So
yeah,
that's a good sign.
Yeah. So. And for you people that are going to do it, like I said, now you got, Tom made that instructional video. You got to do it exactly like he says. If you try some other, you go, oh, I can do it this way. I can do it easier, faster. Don't. It won't work. I tried four different ways and it works the way Tom did it. So if you follow those instructions, you'll be successful. Right, Tom?
Yep. So far, so good.
Yeah. So, I mean, everybody has done it that way. And the important part is, I think that a lot of people try to do, they try to unzip it to the zip drive, right to the USB drive. You can't. You got to do it right on the desktop, then bring it over. For some reason, you get errors. I don't know why, but it just errors out. I tried it and I saw the errors, and then and I even had a problem where I had a bad USB drive. I actually had to do a second drive because the first one, I don't know what happened. It just quit on me. It just said, oh, error and stop. But I put on another USB drive and I followed Tom's instructions. Perfect.
Persistence pays off, so that's good.
It is. Yeah,
Devin's still here. I saw Devin in the comments, but the Saturday promo, I don't know if you missed that or if you were just saving it for when Devin got on chat. Ooh,
let's put that on.
Postpone it up for Devin.
Saturday promo?
Yeah.
Yeah, I missed that one. There it is. Oh, yeah, you're right. Saturday at Cherry Hills this Saturday. Oh, another new course coming out for you, the Devin's Home Course, Denver, Colorado. Yeah, how did I miss over that? That's interesting. I was trying to get through it so fast. I'm probably download the new course installer 2.0. That's exactly what we were just talking about, me and Tom. So do that. The trees are real in every course, Tom says. And $2 for 18 holes for this one, Mr. Tom. What a deal. What a deal.
$5 says Devin doesn't even play it.
probably not. Let me get rid of this Saturday promo.
He likes to troll on Bev and challenge Bev to things, and then doesn't even participate himself. So we'll see what Devin does. I see you've got your own little troll here, the Chuckster.
Oh, there's Chuck is in house. Is he really? I didn't see him. My phone just shut off.
Commenting, trash talking you as usual, the Chuckster.
Mr. Chuck, welcome to the show. There it is.
Bev agrees that Devin is a super flake.
That's too funny. I accidentally closed down my I keep track on the chat here because it's so slow on there. Let's go here. Well, Mr. Chuck, you were able to join in, and there it is, catching up. There he is. It's nice to have someone else to talk to on this show. God, I can't stand Lou's voice. Yes, I have a horrible voice. You better believe it, Mr. Chuck. Mr. Devin's there. There he is. There he is, forcing me to upgrade here. Yep, you got to do it, Devin. We got to do it. Bevin, I almost called him. You're right, Tom.
Devin.
There he is. Mr. Andy just joined us. Look at Andy. I didn't see him before. I'm glad you're here, Mr. Andy. Tom's going to go over some stuff here. I'm going to bring up some screenshots.
Thank Ted for these screenshots. He took the time yesterday to put them all together for us. So yeah. We have a visual to go along with what we're discussing here.
And I just brought it up now, Tom, showing you the course pack. This is with the trees now. Is this right?
Yes.
Michael's.
So the courses that Michael released in 2020 that were from previous arcade editions of PGA that we were able to play through the trees, that has now been fixed. So Timber Hill is going to kick our asses now. And the flags that used to all say EA Sports for these courses now have the correct logo flags, thanks to our buddy Tim.
Nice.
So I'm looking forward to working these into the tournament schedule here.
Beautiful job, man. Thank you, Mr. Tim, for putting the flags on there. Mr. Michael, of course, taking the time to actually do that. You know what? It was really – I'm so glad he got to get to it because it worked out really nicely that he got all of that together for
us. Yeah, for Augusta too. Like, I know it's a couple months later than what he had said. I mean, his life's pretty busy, but for him to really take the time to, put his work stuff aside and his family stuff aside to make sure we have these courses in time for, what Tim calls the holy week of golf. that was really nice of him to do. So thanks to Michael for that.
Yeah, thank you, Michael. Thank you so much. If you are catching the show, thank you so much. And Lundquist here says, thank you, Michael. I got my Rangers stuff up. I'm all happy, Tom.
Hey, let's go Rangers.
Yeah, baby. All right, let's go over the next thing. We're going to do this. We're going to show you the new courses update pack. This is the one that we are on right now. This is the course pack for 2024. That is the one, Michael, one that is just updated. Correct, Tom?
Yeah, so what happened was initially when Michael said he was going to put out the course installer back in December, these are the courses that we had completed, between Brian and Todd Curtis. And so I put a schedule together, that once the installer comes out, we're going to start using these courses.
Mm-hmm.
And then as Michael, got busy with work and there was a delay, it actually afforded Brian an opportunity to add even more courses. But because I had already done the schedule, and the schedule takes, I mean, that's a pain in the butt to try put a schedule together that, you know, double check, triple check, make sure we're not playing one of these courses too close together so you don't play it and then 2 weeks later play it again.
Yeah.
And work out where the real, like where the real PGA is playing a course that we're going to play at the same time. So I had already done the schedule. Mm-hmm. And then of course, Brian just drops a whole whack of more courses. So we're kind of, you know, that's kind of what we're showing here in these graphics is if anybody's like, hey, I want to play Ozarks. Well, we're not going to play it this 2024 season. If you've used Michael's installer, it's on your machine. The files are on your machine for all these courses that we're showing. But we're not going to play them as tournaments quite yet because I've already done a schedule. So when the 2024 season is done and I have to make a new schedule, I will work in the what we've dubbed expansion pack to an expansion pack 3, which you're going to show in these graphics. So
yep. And then here is the okay, so that was the 25 new courses, and here are the 15 new courses for the fall coming up here.
So again, when Michael took some time, you know, putting that installer up, and then Brian made even more courses, we dubbed this the expansion pack. So you can see there are some interesting courses on here. Some of the guys that were in the test group have already played some of these courses. Like I know Ozarks was one that we tested out.
Yep.
The par three, I actually snuck that in just because it was a Masters week. Michael did get it done on time.
That was fun.
I wasn't thinking that we were going to play it. So that was, you know, I had it for next season, but you know, for Tim worked so hard to make that course and Michael got the installer out just in time for Augusta.
Yeah.
Figure why not? I mean, why not throw in the Augusta par three? But, that's the first expansion pack. And again, thanks to Brian for seizing the opportunity that Michael gave us and just said, so sitting around twiddling our thumbs, let's just add more courses.
That's fantastic. Yeah. And then, and like Tom just said, that par three, okay, was made by one of our own members. He made that course using some old software that used to use for the PGA, what was it, fan course making thing?
Yeah, it was the old PC versions of Tiger Woods. I don't know if it was Tiger Woods 2004, 2005, maybe it was in both of those. But I remember back in the day, I had Tiger Woods 2004 on PC, mm-hmm. and you could make your own courses. And I wish I had saved what I made just to see.
Oh, like, really?
I'd love to play them all these years later and see how crappy they were. You know, thought they were good.
You made some of those courses back in the day, then, didn't you?
Back in the day, I made at least two. Wow. I remember. Tim. So I think he got a old like laptop from 2004 from Tony. So Tony, I think, sent him a laptop from 2004, and then Tim had to use that to create or use the old Tiger Woods software and create that course from scratch. And he said, like, you know, if he's working on a course for like an hour, the laptop starts cooking, so he has to shut it down. You can only work like an hour or so at a time. So it's interesting.
The brain says Tiger Woods 06 course designer is what he used. So, yeah. So
of course, I said 2004, 2005, and it turned out to be 2006.
Well, I guess because the 2000 would make sense because the 2006 has the latest TCL files. And for you people that don't know what TCL is, that's because for us geeks, meaning the files that actually have the trees and all the other crap. Am I right when I say that with the TCL files?
I don't know. That's a Brian thing.
Yeah, that is Brian thing. Brian, am I right? Am I wrong? Yeah. All right. So besides that, now let's talk about this new exciting 2025 next course thing. And this is one I'm excited because one of these courses is the Big Lou Ravine. And here's that graphic.
This is one that everybody keeps messaging, asking when we're going to play Big Lou's Water Ravine. I said, you know, we need to make a graphic to let people know they're going to have to patiently wait for 2025. Mm-hmm. You know, we're not just giving everything away for free here. You got to wait a little bit, pay your renewals, and then you can play some Water Ravine.
Yeah, that's right. And what he means by somebody keep bothering him, it's me. No, thank you so much, Tom. Tom did that one for me. I appreciate that, Big Lou's Water Ravine. We got Glen Abbey on there. Look at that.
Yeah, that's a Canadian course. A lot of the Canadian Opens are at Glen Abbey.
Yeah.
I want to say that's around Toronto area, maybe Hamilton area. I can't recall.
Oakville, I'm looking forward to playing that Pepper Ridge, too. That one, I think that one was a really cool one.
Pepper Ridge looks great, but I feel like, I want to say it's hole 13, if I remember, was like a booby trap hole. I think we kind of threw it in for shits and giggles just to fuck over Mike Layton a little bit.
That's going to be great. Yeah. So there's some cool stuff on there. That's coming back up. Now, this will be, you're looking at this stuff now. This will be the next expansion pack that Michael's got to put together. So it's not going to be right away. That's why he's got 2025 on there.
So the installer that everybody's doing right now has these courses in that installer.
Gotcha.
But we won't get to them on a tournament schedule until 2025.
Which makes sense.
Yeah, so it's just one installer. It will add all 71 new courses to your machine, and I'm just letting people know when you can expect to play some of those courses. You know, like I said, the initial 25 and the revamped of the original, like 11 courses, like the Pebble Beach and Timber Hills, that's this 2024 season. And then when I make a new schedule for September, October, November, December, I'll make sure to include the courses that we're showing off here on that chart.
Mr. Andy's asking, can any of these courses be installed on the offline cabs?
That's a good question. I think we're kind of hoping, fingers crossed, that Adam Emsweiler has success. I think I may have mentioned it last time I was on your show, that he's connected with a programmer for hire. And the programmer for hire, I think, is going to work with Adam to see if they can add these courses directly to the Play Golf course select screen.
Wow.
And so if they can figure that out, I mean, that's our preferred, fingers crossed, hopefully everything goes well, add them right to the Play Golf course select screen. And if, you know, Adam comes back, you know, four or five months from now and says that that programmer for hire was unsuccessful, then I think he himself will work on that test bat that we were all using.
Yeah.
And the test, maybe release that to everybody. But the preferred method is obviously the nice, pretty game menu, course select menu with all the course icons there. So it's seamless, but we'll see how it goes. We're definitely going to have them released one way or another in the future.
So this way, Andy, you can practice and get good because just jumping. The cool thing about it is right now, just for everybody, I mean, besides the testers that got to play these courses, which there were so many, it wasn't like somebody got to play it 100 times in practice. You know what I mean? There's 71
and
courses.
And a lot of the people that were playing were just racing through just to kind of get a glimpse of what these courses look like. Mm-hmm. We mentioned it before. You're playing just to make sure you can hit trees, that the water actually, you know, is a penalty. The flags are there, whatever, like that. And those, because people were racing through, I think a lot of them, when they actually played the tournaments, their scores suffered. You mentioned this as well, that you're...
yes!
It seemed to affect your game when it mattered.
It really did.
So I don't know how many people are actually using that test program now, but...
Tom, you're so
right.
I
know I'm not.
Because I got, for some reason, it wrecked my putting because we're racing through and the hole was on level 5, which is the easiest, which is the hole is probably the size of a spaghetti pot. You roll it in. So as you're racing, you're hitting it. And then when you jump back to the online one, the hole's back to being a normal size. And oh my God, how many jump holes I get. I'm so mad at myself. I just can't seem to readjust. But that is it. 71 new courses. So, and I was talking about it, Tom. I put this together last second. I was talking about my cabinet that I was putting together. I was going to show everybody there while I have.
Okay, Have you made some progress with that?
Yeah, I'm going to show you. I put the cab together. I wanted to get everybody's opinion on the slope, too, if you could tell me. But let's look at
this. Ladies and gentlemen, punting from Rupp. Just want to make a quick video here. Making a nice cabinet here. I'm trying to get this guy going.
Yeah.
I've been working on this. I'm slipping around.
Yeah, I've been getting this guy going. I'm putting the button in there. I just put some buttons in there.
I got it all together.
I put the card in here. Didn't have a hole in there. And put a control panel. This is actually from a 2005 PGA, not for one of those Golden Tee 2005. I picked it up off of the internet, and I was putting it together, trying to get it together. The only thing my concern is, and matter of fact, I'm glad I got all of you, slope on that's a little more than a normal slope.
So yeah, talk about the slope on that.
Affect gameplay. Anybody else have that? Anybody else have a slope like that? So the computer's going back in there. I got everything all ready. I got all the wiring done. This is nice. This lights up. I was showing pictures up there. Fastened in a nice wire harness there. So turn it into a pedestal, and I'm going to put another TV up right there. The old cabinet got changed over to the 2K21. Not 2K21. PGA, the Golden Tee 2005. I'll put the marquee. That's where I got that marquee from. Yeah, lights up and everything. What do you think? Cool or not? Button there for coins, and that's going to be it. See what I do. Well, I just wanted to share that with you. And what you think?
So that was the only thing that I'm concerned about is the slope on it is just a little bit extra. But I don't know if it's going to affect the gameplay or not. I didn't know if anybody plays with that high of a slope. But I guess it'll be. Thank you, Andy. Appreciate it. I don't know if you got a chance. You couldn't hear it. Maybe Tom's still listening to it. Let's see.
No, it's just Bev's buddy, Matt, just messaged me on Messenger saying he wants to get online. I'll have to connect with him later. I don't know if he's friends with Bev. What does that say about him?
maybe if he gets it all set up, then he could help Bev. They could work together on it.
Maybe that could help. Yeah. Help us out, pulling our hair out. We're trying to help Bev all the time.
Well, I do appreciate, and everybody does appreciate, for all the work that you put into this online. This is Tom. He takes care of all of the online stuff. He's pretty much the orchestrator of the whole entire community. He's the guy that sits there and has the sticks, and everybody's doing this, and he's putting this together with that person and that person and this person. So he is the magic man that takes care of all of that stuff. That's who you're looking at.
Thanks. That's flattering of you, Lou.
Yeah, well, hey, credit
actually, you know what? That's a good segue for, I want to say hi if my neighbor is watching, Josh Perry. I restored a machine back home. It's actually on a YouTube video where Brian and Turtle play it to test it out.
Nice.
I brought that with me down here to the States, and then my neighbor ended up buying it. You may have seen him on the leaderboards. He's not doing too hot right now. He's just starting out. His name's Pete. If you look at the leaderboards, I think he's over par so far.
Yeah. But hey, we all start there.
And he'll be whooping everyone.
Hey, listen, we all and start then, there.
Yeah, that's what I told him. You can't compare yourself to guys who've been playing for 7-8 years. You got to compare yourself to the guys who are starting off. And one of them is another guy I sold a machine to just a little bit north of me in Tennessee. His name is Kevin Dodson. I'm going to be getting his machine online in the next week or two. He's really looking forward to playing online. He's always messaging, Tom, has my stuff come in yet? And I had to order him a card reader, and Brian was kind enough to send a new hard drive all ready to go. So look for those guys. But
nice.
A couple Southern players coming into the mix soon.
Beautiful. Well, congratulations. Welcome to the community. I'm so happy, and you guys will just keep practicing and getting better and better. I just saw Double Door was saying he was GPing to ask you guys that found the programmer. What was that all about?
Yeah, that he was going to ask about the programmer, which I just mentioned about Adam looking for a programmer for hire.
Oh, that was what you were talking about. I see. Yeah, because I was wondering what the heck that was. Okay.
And
I
then
see.
Andy Morris says he needs more tidbits. Sorry, my man. Corey doesn't want to pay up anymore. he used to pitch me some. Just kidding. I think when Shane Keane said he was going to do some Axel's Pen episodes, I kind of, was like, all right, maybe you can show some tips that I haven't shared yet. And so I don't know. Maybe we'll see. We'll if people want more tidbits,
I get some of the
old
ones.
Coach my wife and be a cameraman again.
If I get some of the old ones, I'll put them on my show. It don't matter to me. I throw them in there. I'll throw a little bit of old school Tommy tidbits. And what that used to be is, for anybody that's new that you're watching, he used to do little helpful videos for you and stuff like that. So it was really cool stuff that I actually forget. It was cabinet stuff you used to do, right, Tom?
I think one was like how to clean your trackball. One was how to dust out the computer, because people would drop off computers at my house back when I lived in London, and I'd open them up and be friggin' dust bunnies inside. Most of the time, I think that Wayne Jennings, Bish's buddy, he had the cleanest computer I'd ever seen. I was like totally expecting it to be dirty, but no, it was really clean.
Well, that, so. Yeah, those would be really helpful, especially that we have a bunch of new community members that are joining on the offline site, and you know, they're learning how to get their cabinets up and running and getting them slowly but surely together. So yeah, so I'll reach out to Corey. Corey has all of those. I might be able to find them online. Those
yeah, they're on YouTube. I think I've got a bunch of people in the group who follow my YouTube channel. I think one where I explain how to hit for extra speed or power or whatever like that. That one has like 700 views. It's the most. Nobody wants the tips on chipping. They all want tips on how to drive the ball farther. So,
well,
that's the most popular one.
I got to thank Tom, because out of one of his Tommy tidbits, I think it was you that actually said when you're in the trap, you lob it out instead of, because you can't get above. And it was one of your tips, right?
I think I explained when the best scenario is for each, whether it's the lob, the regular chip, or the bump and run.
Yeah. I use that all the time. I use it all the time, my friend. Thank you very much. Thank you, Bev.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you about the pedestal. And like I said, the nice thing about the slope is that the two outer white things, I can always tip those up and put a spacer and bring that control panel up a little level. But I'll keep you all up informed and let you know how that slope
is. It reminds me of Tony's pedestal cabinet, because Tony's is like a Golden Tee PGA hybrid, kind of what you've got going on there.
And he plays
the white sides. The white sides, even you know, the machine I built for my neighbor that's used to be a Golden Tee or Silver Strike cabinet. I like those white sides.
Yeah. I got to get Mark. I'm going to talk to him about getting that nice little sticker. Yeah, that white sticker and sticking on the front. I think that will really touch it in, and getting one of the Global VR card stickers.
With the white sides on there, for sure.
Oh, that's so sharp. That graphic that you put on. Tommy had that when he built his cabinet. He shows you how he puts the label on the side. So, and it's got that cool graphic that and I think Global VR still has that. I asked Tommy the other day, and he got them from Mark. Yeah,
they can print them. Oh, later, Brian. Thanks for joining us.
Brian, thank you, buddy. Thank you so much. Yep, we're going to be going ourselves. I was going to head on out. I was going to show Chris. We'll save that for the next show. I kind of put that on there. So that's Chris Rusnik's. I want to show his cool setup. We'll do that next Big Lou show in two Thursdays from now. And I want to thank you, Tommy, and talk about the updates and let everybody know, please. Again, I can't stress on how important it is to follow Tom's exact instructions when you're doing this Course Installer 2.0 update.
Lou. I want to mention that Corey and Todd and Tim and Kush and Micah are currently in discussions about having another team event. Some of you may have seen a poll I put up on the Facebook page a while back asking how many people would be interested in it, because we kind of taken a break from them. I feel like maybe we overdid it for a little bit and people weren't so enthused about it anymore. But we've taken a good long break, and so judging from the reaction or the feedback we got, seems people want to play another team event, and those guys are trying to figure out the best week and the best course to do. And because we got all new courses, no one really is going to know what to expect. I mean, who knows? Curtis Cliffs, if they pick that, that's a deadly course, I'll tell you. So,
oh yeah, I'm looking forward to that. Yeah, Devin, so if somebody could help you out, I did have a way that I could sign into cabinets, but it requires being able to go into your router and open up a port for me to get to the software, because none of the Telnet softwares you can't use, some of the ports that are used already. So I do have a way to get in the cabinet, but you have to open up a port, and then I could get into your cabinet and do it for you. But if you're a network guy and you know how to open ports in your router, let me know and I could help you out. Port 5900, and then I could put a software on your cab, and I can actually Telnet into your machine and control it via remote and put all of the stuff on there. It's too bad I couldn't find an easier port, Tom. I was trying to find out a way that we can use like TeamViewer into the people's cabinets, but so far I haven't been successful. I've been trying different ports and stuff like that to see if I, you know, one of the ones that are already open, meaning that it's almost like a ship port, you know, you have to have a certain number open, so it tells the, when you go from your machine and you're trying to sign into it, it knows how to communicate to the golf game. So, but I'm still working on it. I'm not going to quit on you guys. I may find a way. So, and then we'll be able to help you remotely, and that's going to be extremely helpful, because that'll take a lot of pressure off of a lot of people that don't have the skills that's necessary to do this type of stuff to update.
If you're okay with, like, how are you doing for time? Because I'd like to mention something, unless you
got... No, go right ahead. No, go ahead. Yep, yep.
So I was on vacation in Florida a couple weeks ago, and I asked Brian to load a tournament for me while I was away because I wasn't going to bring my laptop. And to no fault of Brian, the server duplicated a tournament. So he scheduled the tournament for April 1st to 7th, and it loaded it, but then it duplicated it for also May 1st to 7th, which... is weird because that's like a Wednesday to a Tuesday. It's not even like a Monday to Sunday. Mm-hmm. And so just a heads up that I've asked Michael if he could take that down. I'm waiting for him to look at the message and see if he will delete it for us. But if not, we've got this bizarre duplicate tournament coming up on the schedule. It's a True North Monument, which we just played. So I don't know that I would include that on the, you know, the season standings or anything. It's mm-hmm. like I said, a bizarre Wednesday to Tuesday, but because it's a weird Wednesday to Tuesday, it kind of interferes with 2 weeks of tournaments. And the tournament schedule, we're going to be Black Diamond Quarry Course. It was supposed to be Monday to Sunday, but now we've got this weird tournament there. And then I can't remember what the following week was, but that was a problem because initially that's what Corey wanted for this team event, to be Black Diamond Quarry Course. Mm-hmm. And this stupid duplicate tournament just screwed Pooch. Which is why I'm saying that they're in discussions now, because now they got to go back and figure out what their schedules are for a second date or a different week and pick a different course. You know, even if Michael shows up tomorrow and just deletes it, there's still not enough time now to use.
Oh,
that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
so we would have been having fun in a couple weeks, but, you know, we'll still have fun.
That's right. Yep. We still got, plenty of time, plenty of, we got plenty of time and to do a lot of that stuff. So we're going to it's the greatest thing in the world is this, all this new stuff. It's so exciting for everybody.
Yeah. And next week, we've got a new course. So we've got the Cherry Hill. You showed the Saturday promo, mm-hmm. promo there, the Cherry Hill, Devin's backyard on Saturday. Next week, we've got the Australian course for the first time, Bilby Crossing. That's a fictional Australian course. And then on that the Saturday, not this upcoming Saturday, but the Saturday after that, we've got my local course, TPC nice. Southwind, which is like 15 minutes from here. So I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah. That's new fun stuff. Like, yeah.
All the time, new stuff.
That's what I was saying. We're going to be able to play with the pros a lot more. Loved it. I loved it. We were just on the course. We got Quail Hollow, which is right here by me, too. So it's only 15, 20 minutes from me. So we got these courses that are coming out, but it might be a course by you.
Yes, and Quail Hollow, I think, is the other course that this stupid duplicate tournament is kind of thrown into the air.
Oh, really? Oh, boy.
Yeah, so we'll have to figure something out, because if that duplicate tournament ends on a Tuesday, maybe we could run Quail Hollow Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Yeah. Make it a short week, but still Quail Hollow when the PGA plays Quail Hollow. So
nice.
Have to figure it out.
Well, thank you, Tom, for putting all of this schedule together. I know it's not easy, and double loading is not fun, but hey, we work around it. You know, what are we going to do? That's what we do.
Yeah.
We work through it together as a community. This is all it's all about. So if you don't have any more, I don't have any more. If you have more, just let them know.
No, that's everything. Just say hi to Andy and Corey and Devin, Bev, Brian, who left. Who else is on here? Stutz. Stopped in. Yeah, all these guys saying hello to both of us here. So thought I'd say hello before we call it a night.
Duke, yep. And for everybody that's watching the replay, thank you very much for watching the replay. And you'll get to see what's going on with your fun.
Oh, Thunder Spy as well.
Yep. Oh, Thunder Spy was there. Yep. So many people. We had a good crowd tonight. Good crowd. Thank you for joining us, everybody, for coming in.
Yeah.
Having fun on the Big Lou Show. And next, I don't know if those guys are going to do the Monday. They usually jump a Monday because they don't have anything for you, because all the shots of the week, I suck them all up on Thursday. So unless there's a lot of shots of the week, I don't think those guys will have a show this Monday. They'll probably have it next Monday, and I'll do the next Thursday after their show, whatever it might be. So, Tom, thank you so much again for joining the Big Lou Show, and I am going to call it. It's 9 o'clock. People are ready to go to work and go to bed for work. That's what I'm about to do. Thank you so much, everybody. And you know Corey's saying, listen to you. Everyone, always remember to hit them long, and remember the putt from the rough. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You have a great
Later,
night.
Everybody. Thanks for having me on, Lou.
Thank you very much, Tom, for giving us all the updates, and I will see everybody soon. Thank you very much. Big Lou, signing out.
Hey, Lou, you forgot to say goodnight to me.
Oh, goodnight, Rob.
Goodnight, Lou.